This is a very sensitive, shy, totally different than what we would see on camera.
Yes.
Totally different. And
well, that's acting.
And that shows me that you have talent.
Thank you.
No, really, because I just did a show with a friend of mine, Silva, and we were talking about I'm an actor, and the greatest actors that I know are the ones who are comfortable with themselves mm-hmm. and are shy, and they don't have to prove to the outside world who they are.
Yeah, I don't need to be a walking press kit. I can't stand people like that.
Yeah, and
so stop talking about yourself for a moment. Let's find out who you actually are, not what everything that you've done.
Let's talk about how you went about doing this movie, auditions, Julie Simone's audition. Now, how did you go about doing this, auditioning for, and directing this and writing this?
Well, I wrote the script, and then I had Dana DeArmond, who's done a lot of stuff with Vivid Alt. I was the initial lead, but she wanted to use a different male top. It was just this porno guy, and I went to this website, and he didn't even know how to hold the implements. And I'm like, there's no way he's going to be like a good dom and believable dom. And Master Liam is somebody that I performs at the different clubs, and he and I got along really well because he's also isn't a lot of doms are more about themselves and their egos, and he's not like that. And I was like, this is somebody I can actually work with who can read this and appreciate it, not try to take over the ship because it's my ship, it's not anybody else's ship. And so we shot it all in one day. Gia Paloma, I'm sorry, I met her at a party, and she actually happened to be on the website that I was told to go to look at this other actor.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, I didn't even know she did that kind of stuff. And I talked to her about the idea, and she was totally into it. And her take on it was that when she was growing up, and you watch shows on TV, and like the girl gets abducted, she's like, this is how I always wanted it to end, but it never did. She's like, so she was finally living out a fantasy she's had since a child, which was great.
And there are women who like to be raped, aren't there?
They like the idea.
The idea, not only
going
out in the street and getting raped by a stranger, but the idea.
Yeah, and I used to have a huge rape fantasy. I would, when I lived in D.C. and I'd come to L.A. for work, I had a lover that I would call and be like, well, I'm going to be going to Ralph's near the Beverly Center later, if you want to drive around the parking garage or something, and it's like it was exciting to fantasize about being snatched in the parking garage in a van or a pickup or something and just taken away.
God, where were you when I was a kid? That's incredible. I mean, that is so wonderful to hear when, that there are people like yourself out there who really believe and feel and act on it, if possible.
When possible.
If possible, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's done right. The rape scenes and all this and that, because I guess a lot of men, too, would like to, that feeling of power and just be able to do what they want.
And people are too caught up in what's politically correct anymore.
Correct, yeah.
And they have these ideas like it's not okay to be turned on by violence. But on the other hand, people are going to see all these torture movies. It's like they're being turned on by that violence. That's why they're going to it.
Yeah.
But they, because there's no sex in those movies, then it's okay.
Yeah.
And it's just
true,
like
true. Yeah.
And it's like that's why those movies are making all that money. That's let's just admit it.
Yes, it's right. The politically correctness is the downfall of civilization
society,
because no one is allowed to breathe, much less think.
Right.
I mean, it really is. I mean, you're afraid to say anything, to joke and this and that. And I go back to the 60s in Greenwich Village, where everything was open. Everything was available, mm-hmm. and it was there, and it was safe. You could do it. You could say it.
Right.
And it's just not that way. So when you come out with something like this and classes like yours, it must be such a rewarding and liberating feeling for a lot of you.
It is when people come up and tell me that they've watched this and, when I get their reactions. I mean, simply just making it isn't as liberating as it could be, as it probably should be.
Yeah.
I mean, it's nice to do it, but, it's like you want it to be seen. You want people to think. Like, and that's what I think most art should be about. And I mean, some people would just say, oh, this is just some violent porn. But, there's, in a lot of ways, to me, there's, my movies, I try to make them like art. It's like, when you watch it, I want you to think something. I want you to feel something. I don't want you to just be watching some mindless activities. Like,
Did
everything
you study
happens for a reason.
Film?
I studied English theory.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a deconstructionist theory.
Oh. And so how did you, and to become a director and this and that, how did that all?
It kind of happened by accident. I mean, I put up a website because I was tired of, I was working with all these photographers and I thought their work was crap. I was like, I can do better than this. Like, anybody can do better than this. You know, let's make the girls actually look pretty and, you know, have, use nice sets and have a plot that's more involved than, you know, guy grabs girl in the woods. And, you know, it's like a lot of the stuff that was being made at the time, it was like around 2000, 1999, was just crap. And so I put up my site and that's kind of how it started. So then I started directing photo shoots and then video projects came along as people requested them.
Well, video now, you can shoot all day long, and it's right. So inexpensive, and the internet. And you know, I've had some adult stars on my on the show here, and I always encourage them about taking lessons in acting, because I find when I teach acting, I always want my actors to be able to go anywhere. Mm-hmm. You have to be free to be able to get naked,
right.
You know, from the inside out. And I find people in the porn industry are that way. When I say that they're naked, they are. They're willing to go anywhere. And I respect that so much. And there's so much talent to be reckoned there. And with the internet now and this and that, you have to have talent if you want to last.
Right. Or a good publicist.
But that's only going to take you so far. But to come up with such a creative idea as this. And the, and if I could just show this. If we can get this here, I mean, it's such a great, I mean, the artwork and everything, it's so creative. I mean, it's almost like it's inspirational. I'm looking at it and saying, this is wonderful, because the imagination is automatically open when I look at this. I don't see anything dirty or anything like or porn. This I'm seeing, what is, this is something interesting.
I really wanted to make a cover that was PG-13, that could be hung anywhere.
Oh, great. Well, that is.
Yeah, because, you know, it's like a lot of magazines won't publish your covers if there's nudity, or ever since the 2257 laws came out, it's been, people are just really overly cautious.
Now, is this the first film, or do you have other films you've done?
That is my 11th release for my company. Oh. I've directed about, I think, at least 20 movies total.
Now, I can't give out websites, but people can Google your name.
Right.
And it'll all come up. So I would highly recommend that you do that. And that's wonderful. So you've done 11. So you've been
11 in a year and a half.
God, you look 16 too. I mean, I'm sorry. In a year and a half?
Yeah.
Maronda mia.
Last year I put out 8 movies.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. 8 movies. I'm in the wrong business. I'm in the wrong acting business. You know, I mean. I go over to your side, but it's non-union, I can't work. I don't know if we can work in porn. You know, I'm a SAG member. Can SAG people work with you?
I don't know. You might have to use a fake name.
I'm not ashamed of my name, but I guess you would have to, I guess.
I don't really know a whole lot about that, unfortunately.
I should find out about that, but I'll get a little bit. I tried to do a sex, you know, porn movie once. Back in the 70s,
mm-hmm.
And it just, you know, that's hard work.
Yeah.
You know, for a man, you know, no pun intended.
Sometimes it's not hard, and then, you know, you spend hours waiting around, like.
Yes, but today they have Viagra and this and that.
I did a shoot with a guy, and he was on Viagra, and it didn't work. It was a smoking fetish shoot, and the smoke kept bothering him, so he was having problems, and then. So then we had to come back the next week, and he had like Viagra and Cialis, and so he just was so high that like he's like a corpse. Like the girl's having sex with him, he just kind of like, I was like, oh my
really?
Goodness.
Oh, yeah. They get so high. You gotta
balance it out.
You have to balance it, I guess, yeah.